Good morning, Leiden. I'm Franco.
And I'm Brian.
On today's Eagle Update, we are going to be covering a Penny update, last Friday's dodgeball tournament, and pancakes with the principal.
Today is March 1st, and your Eagle Update starts at 5. Penny the therapy dog has been at East Leyden now for a whole month, and it has truly been catching the eyes of staff and students. Here's an update on how Penny's training is doing.
Penny has been training in the Leyden halls for a little over a month. She has been trained on how to react to students in the halls and staying put when people pass by or call her name. We have caught up with Ms. Muldoon to see how Penny is doing.
She has been in many different situations already. So she has worked with students in my office, in the dean's office, with the police, with Sergeant O'Connor. I think one of the best things is seeing her walk down the hall. As soon as we're seen, everybody's head picks up, everybody smiles, and that just warms my heart because it is impacting people every day, all the time.
One of the classes that Penny has visited is Ms. Scafidi's class.
So Ms. Muldoon's dog has really been a calming force to a lot of us. She actually stopped by with her dog to my badminton class, and a lot of the girls stopped over and petted her and everything and took a little time out for that. But it's just so nice to have her in the building. I love dogs tremendously, and I know a lot of people do too. And it's just really been a nice addition to our school, having her in the building.
One of the things that I would love to just remind people, when she's in the hallway, we are going from point A to point B, and we've got to get there. So the hallways are really off limit for petting. She just can't do that. We're working on getting some meet and greets in different areas of the building that students can still come and just visit with her.
If you want to meet with Penny, contact your counselor or Ms. Muldoon to set up a meeting. Let's hope that Penny will help more students this next few months.
Last Friday, Leiden hosted a dodgeball tournament to raise money for Rocco Britain. Over 10 teams came together to support this cause.
We got some guys together and wanted to do something for Rocco. He's become kind of a fixture here at Leiden, with Kai being involved in so many things. We've gotten to know the family, and you know, he's going through a rare spinal condition right now, and you get to know him and the family, and they're just great people, and you want to do what you can to help out. And what a fun way to do it, to have an event like this, raise a few funds, and hopefully be able to help the family as well. Rocco's got a few surgeries and a few medical expenses ahead of him. He's going to have to take a trip out to Philadelphia to meet with some doctors that can hopefully provide some answers for them. So there's a lot of expenses whenever you're dealing with those types of things. So that's where the money's going, to try to help offset some of those costs and help our man out. And Rocco is such a cute kid. He's always all smiles. Break charts, you know, he's going through some stuff medically because his personality is off the charts. He's so fun. You know, and then you also get to see just how mature and how great a big brother Kyler is. And I could not be more proud of him. And I couldn't be more proud to be a part of this event.
With all the money going towards Rocco's medical treatments for the future, his parents and his brother Kyler couldn't have been any more happy to express their thoughts and gratitude on the event.
It means so much to us. Leiden has been so good to us. And through Rocco's battle, we just can't thank everyone enough.
It was a good experience, you know, it was a good turnout. Thanks to everyone in the school who supports me and my family. I really appreciate it. Overall, it was fun though.
We hope that Rocco gets the help he needs and gets better faster for the future. And now, back to the studio.
A couple times a month, Leiden has a Pancakes with the Principal event. This is where you can go meet with Mr. Markey and talk about issues around the school.
With Leiden trying to get students' perspective on what should be changed and kept at Leiden, Mr. Markey meets with second period classes to discuss problems and new ideas for the school.
Like, I come into a class and we provide pancakes from either advanced catering or our food services program, and we sit and we talk about school with the principal. So the topics are wide open. Either the teacher and the class kind of determine a couple of topics they want to talk about, or more generally, we just talk about things that they really like about Leiden, so I don't screw anything up that we're doing right, things that they want to add to Leiden, or what they would want to change if they were principal for a day. The primary benefit is that I can hear from a large number of students across a lot of different grade levels and classes, and really get feedback on students of what they're looking for out of our school and what they like most about it. So the teachers just simply sign up via a Google form we sent out at the beginning of the semester, and we were looking for teachers and classes that were interested, and we filled up, I think, close to 20 dates. So Pancakes with the Principal is probably coming to you.
We also met with a student on the receiving end of the breakfast.
He asked us what we wanted to keep and change with the new construction here at Leyden. We don't want split periods anymore. We also wanted to keep music in the hallways and stuff like that. I really liked the breakfast. Felt like the talk was nice and the food was good. I think all the students got to like say what they thought, and it was beneficial.
Remember, if you are looking to become an Access Mentor for the 2019-2020 school year, here is Ms. Khan on that.
I just wanted to give you some information about upcoming mentor applications. Our informational meeting is March 7th, which is next Thursday. We will meet in the auditorium at 2:35 during the access time period, and then applications will be due the Thursday before spring break. All right, I have really enjoyed being a part of the Access program and getting to know the juniors and seniors as mentors, but as well as the freshmen. And I think that it's a great program to be a part of because, number one, it looks really great on your college applications. And then they really get a chance to build great relationships with their fellow mentors, their advisors, their teachers, and as well as the freshmen.
Is that you can build on your leadership skills and you can build on your college application.
There's community service hours and feeling good about helping freshmen out.
Well, that's all the time we have for today, but we saved some room for cookies. The Flying Eagle, please.
And the winner is Mr. Poggio, Second Period Adventure Education. I'm Franco.
And I'm Brian.
And we're
signing off.
Now I can see that you're falling apart from the way that it used to be, yeah. No matter the distance, I want you to know that deep down inside of me, you are my fire, the one desire. You are, you are, you are.